6:80's Chris McCusker joins us now. Chris, the markets ended on a dark note in 2018, but it looks like things are getting brighter for investors.
Yes, definitely. So far, so good for 2019. Markets higher for a fourth straight day today. And actually, on a percentage basis, the TSX was the best performer in North America, higher by 1.3%. Oil was higher for an eighth day. Some data released today, and we also saw a weaker U.S. dollar. Now, stateside, you just heard Melissa talking about this. The shutdown drama continues with the U.S. president walking out of a meeting with top Democrats, calling it a waste of time. Seems markets are looking past that and are still focused on the optimism around the U.S.-China trade talks, although markets in the U.S. did finish off their highs for the day.
So this morning, no movement from the Bank of Canada on interest rates. What does that actually say about our economy right now?
It's sort of interesting. Some of the commentary from the bank was, how do I put this? Confusing, maybe? Our loonie today did close at a four-week high. Interest rates remain unchanged, so that's good for anyone who owes money. The central bank seemed to convey a less urgent message on higher interest rates as the economy still deals with slumping Canadian oil prices. So that was cited as a factor. The central bank also cited weaker than expected consumption and housing activity and suggested that the five hikes since the middle of 2017 might be having a stronger impact than expected. Now, at the same time, the Bank of Canada governor said that our economy remains on solid footing, that it's been operating at full capacity for more than a year despite headwinds. And the bank also cut its forecast for growth for the final 3 months of 2017. It also expects a further slowdown in the first 3 months of this year. And the inflation outlook has also been revised lower. So maybe if I were to sum it up, I'd say a little bit of everything.
Yeah. So if you're lucky enough to own a mansion, I know you are, I'm not. You've got your place, what, 25,000 square feet, three indoor pools, seven-car garage?
Well,
it looks like you won't be selling anytime soon.
That's right. Luxury sales have slowed down in Canada. A drop in the three biggest cities in Canada, including Toronto. This is a report from Sotheby's International Realty, which says home buyers retreated amid tightened mortgage guidelines, which we just cited, and higher interest rates. Oh, that's coming up again. We also saw large declines in Vancouver and Calgary because of tighter supply, higher foreign buyers' taxes, so that's an issue in BC, and then strained economic conditions, again, due to the falling price of crude. So the number of homes sold over $1 million in Toronto dropped by 19%. Sales of homes over $4 million and more dropped by 39%. Now, analysts say that they are expecting growth in Toronto in 2019, but not quite at the unprecedented pace that we've seen in the last couple of years.
So baseball players might be crying the blues over their pay. Payrolls are down across the MLB. The league's explanation for that?
It's a really interesting one. Drug and domestic violence suspensions, along with a player retiring at midseason. So spending on Major League Baseball payrolls dropped last season for the first time since 2010. A decrease of $18 million. This is really unusual for Major League Baseball. Since 2002, it's only happened twice. Couple of players on the list, and I think we've got a board for this. Former Blue Jays closer Roberto Osuna is one of them. Now, charges against him were eventually dropped. The suspension, though, still cost him about $2 million. As far as payrolls overall, the World Series champion Boston Red Sox had the highest payroll for the first time since the free agent era started in 1976. That was at $230 million. San Francisco number two, the Chicago Cubs number three. And can guess where the Blue Jays fell, Francis?
I don't even know how many teams are in the league, but I'll say number eight.
How did you know that?
Was it number eight?
Number eight. You're psychic.
Just lucky number eight, you know.
Okay.
So there we are, number eight, okay.
Number eight, yeah.
All right. Chris, thanks so much.
Okay, have a good night.
Okay, you too. Here's Adrian.